So now we will discuss our the case we have taken earlier. There will be a resistance, there will be an inductor, and there will be a capacitance, and all are connected to a AC source. Okay. Now again our super trick. Super trick is what? Phasor diagram. Phasor diagram. This is the road. Resistance, this is kuan, capacitance, and this is inductor lamp. Okay, now our main motive is to find the current in that circuit. To find the current, we should know the Z, because we know the V. V is what? V equal to V naught sin omega t. So we have to find the Z, impedance of the circuit. So how to find it? So first of all, what we will do? Let us assume that we know XC equal to 1 upon omega C and XL equal to omega L. So let us assume that XL is greater than XC. If XL is greater than XC, then net will be what? Then net will be XL minus XC. Okay, and it's resultant, it is R, X minus XC, so resultant will be this. So Z will be what? That is hypotenuse. You can take this parallel. This is what? XL minus XC. You can take this parallel. So Z is what? It is hypotenuse. So it will be what? XL minus XC whole square plus R square, the under root. So it will be what? Our impedance. And we will put the value. When we put the value, XL value is what? Omega L, and it is 1 upon omega C, the whole square plus R square. So this is our Z. So we want current. So current is what? We know V equal to IZ. V naught equal to I naught Z. So I naught will be V naught by Z. So just put the value of Z this. We get what? I naught in the circuit. Okay. So this was about the. Now our next thing is to prove. Our next thing is to prove that has come in the sample paper. Our next thing is to prove that proof resistance of capacitance is 1 upon omega C. We have to prove it. It is very, very simple. Let us prove it. This is the capacitance and this is the AC source. Okay. So what we know that V equal to V naught sin omega T, and its capacitance is C. So according to Farad law, what Farad law is that? Farad law is Q equal to CV. So Q equal to C, and V value is V naught sin omega T. And what we know? We know what? I equal to Q by T. So d by dt, do d by dt on both sides. So this dq by dt will become I. So it will be, I can write I. And C and V naught is constant. And d by dt of sin omega t. So the differentiation of sin omega t will be omega cos omega t. So it will be I equal to C V naught omega cos omega t. Or we can write I equal to C V naught omega sin omega t plus pi by 2. Sin pi by 2 plus theta equal to cos theta. So we can write this also. So to get the value of maximum this I naught, to get the value of the maximum value of I, what we have to do that? We have to make this value as what? 1. We have to, because the maximum value of sin is 1, when the maximum value of sin will become 1, this current will become maximum. So I naught will be what? CV naught omega. I naught will become CV naught omega. And what we know? We know V naught equal to I upon resistance. According to Ohm's law, we know what? V naught equal to I naught XC. So XC will be what? V naught by I naught will be XC. V naught and I naught is what? C V naught omega XC. So V naught, V naught cancel. So XC will be 1 upon omega C. Hence proved. Okay. So this was very simple to prove XC equal to 1 upon omega C. So this is how we prove x equal to 1 upon omega c. Thank you.